Section 1.3, Multiplying and Dividing Integers. This video will help you multiply and divide two signed numbers, multiply and divide several signed numbers. Alright, when multiplying or dividing, we use we use real simple rules here to figure out the sign of the product, which is multiplication, or the quotient, which is division. And so here they are. So opposite signs are going to give us a negative answer. So notice if I take a positive number times a negative number, those signs are opposite, I'm going to get a negative answer. And if we reverse that, same thing, negative times positive, I'm going to get a negative answer. The other rule is this: if we have the same signs, we're going to get a positive answer. And this works whether we're multiplying or dividing. And we've done this one several times, a positive times a positive, we know we get a positive answer there. Well, if we take a negative times a negative, we're also going to get a positive answer. And the same thing holds true for division here. Two positives or two negatives are going to give us a positive answer. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to multiply and divide positive and negative integers. All right, example one, we're asked to multiply positive 6 times negative 5. Well, those are different signs, so we know we're going to get a negative answer. So once we get our negative sign down there, now we'll just focus on whatever 6 times 5 is. Well, 6 times 5 is 30, so my answer there is going to be negative 30. Example 2. I'm dividing negative 16 by negative 2. Same signs here, so we're going to get a positive answer. So I can write that positive sign, or I could just leave it blank. Either way, it indicates it's positive. Then I can just focus on the division. 16 divided by 2 is 8. All right, question 3. We're asked to multiply negative 4 times negative 8. Again, same sign, so that's going to give me a positive answer. 4 times 8 is going to be 32, so positive 32. Here, we want to be a little bit careful. 6 divided by 0. Well, so division by 0 is impossible, because basically what happens when we're dividing something, we're splitting it up. And we really can't split something up into zero parts. Zero parts really doesn't exist. So this problem is impossible. But in mathematics, we've learned never to say never. So what we do when we think something's impossible is we say undefined, meaning no one has figured this out yet. So we don't know what the answer is. Most likely, this is going to end up being impossible. But at this point, we're just saying, hey, nobody knows. All right, question 5. 4 divided into 0. Now, 4 can go into 0, and it goes in there 0 times, because if I take 4 times 0, it gives me 0. That means 4 goes into 0 0 times. So if I am dividing 0 by another number, I can actually get an answer there, because all we're doing is splitting up 0 into parts, and there would be 0 in each of those parts. Or you could think about the multiplication problem. 4 times 0 will give you 0. So this actually works. When we're dividing 0 into parts, we get 0. But if we're trying to divide by 0, then we end up getting undefined. Okay, pause your video player now and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 6. We're asked to multiply two negatives here, so we know that's going to give us a positive answer. Then we can focus. 7 times 8 is just going to give us 56. So positive 56 there. Question 7. Different signs here, so we're going to get a negative answer. Then we would say, okay, 10 divided by 5 is 2. So negative 2 for our answer there. Let's see. Question 8. Different signs, so negative answer. And 9 goes into 36 4 times, so negative 4. Question 9. We're starting with 0, and we are dividing that into two parts. We can do this. We can split 0 up into two parts. Each of those parts would have 0. Question 10. Now we're asked to figure out how many times 0 goes into 12. Well, it's not going to work, because we're really essentially dividing by 0 here. So this is going to be undefined. Multiply and divide several integers. Two simple rules can be used to determine the sign of several products. Again, that's multiplication, or quotients, which is division, or a combination of the two. And the first rule is this: if we have an even number of negatives in our list of things getting multiplied together, we're going to end up having a positive answer. So you can see here in this first list, I have two negatives, which is an even number of negatives. We're going to end up with a positive answer here. Reason being that every time I pair up two of these negatives, I'm going to get a positive answer. So when I pair those two up, it's going to give me a positive answer. And so if there's an even number, they all get paired up, and that's how we end up with a positive answer. Second example here, it looks like I have 1, 2, 3, 4 number of negatives there, and so that's also going to give me a positive answer. Next rule is this. An odd number of negatives gives us a negative answer. Okay, so if we're looking at this problem right here, I have 1 negative, so that is going to give me a negative answer. And then the second one here, I have 1, 2, 3 negatives, so that's also going to give me a negative answer. The way this works is, basically these first two negatives would pair up to make a positive, and then we have 1 negative left over, and that 1 negative left over, that is going to give us a negative answer, because our signs will be different. I'll have a positive times a negative. Let's take a look at an example here that will help you understand this. Okay, example 11, we're asked to evaluate, which means get this down to a single answer. And I'm going to multiply and divide here. And what we do with multiplication and division is we work left to right, because those tie in the order of operations. So let's see, I would start here and multiply the negative 3 times the negative 5. Well, that's going to give us a positive 15. I'd rewrite the rest of the problem. Still working left to right now. 15 times 2 is going to give me 30. Come over here to finish. And then the last step, 30 divided by 6 is going to give me a positive 5. Now let's double check. We've done this work. Let's double check and make sure the sign on this answer is what it should be. So if I go back to the original problem, I had an even number of negatives in there. So that should give me a positive answer, and I ended up with a positive answer, so I have confidence in that answer. Go ahead now and pause your video player and answer practice question 12. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, question 12. Some multiplication and division here, so we're going to work left to right, so I'd start right here. 6 and negative 2, so that's going to give me a negative answer. 6 divided by 2 is 3. Then I'm going to rewrite the rest of the problem. Okay, still working left to right. Negative 3 times negative 8. Signs are the same, so that's going to give me a positive answer. So positive 24 divided by negative 4. Last step, let's see, it's going to give me a negative answer, and then 24 divided by 4 is going to give me 6. So I get a final answer there of negative 6. Go ahead and pause your video player again and work some of these practice questions. Maybe work these 13 through 18. And when you get done, hit play and I'll show you the answers there so you can see how you did. Okay, take a look at the answers here and see how you did. Let me talk a little bit about 16 here, because 16 was a little tricky. So negative 4, while it does divide into positive 10, it doesn't go in there evenly. So I think it might be a little easier to think of this, instead of writing the division this way in long division form, writing it over here as a fraction. This is something we're probably more used to. And so I'd say, okay, well, I know my answer is going to be negative because I have a positive and a negative, so I wrote the negative sign. Then I said, okay, 4 goes into 10 two whole times, with a remainder of 2, and then you write that remainder over the original divisor. So really what we end up with here is negative 2 and 2 fourths, and then when we simplify 2 fourths, we get 1 half. So our final simplified answer there should be negative 2 and a half. Okay, so now it's time to go ahead and pause your video player again, and let's get some more practice now. I've mixed it up here, so we have both addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, and that's one of the harder things to do, is to kind of keep the signs all straight and the rules all straight as we do this. So go ahead and work these practice problems, 19 through 32, and when you're done, hit play, and you can check your answers. I'll post some answers here for you. Okay, go ahead and check your answers now, and see if your answers match up with the answers I have here. If you've made a mistake, go back and try to correct it. It's easy to make mistakes here and get your signs and your operations mixed up. So go ahead and double check these and see how you did. If you made a mistake, go ahead and fix it. Okay, go ahead and pause your video player again, and I'll work questions 33 through 44. So get down to 44 here, and when you're done with those, go ahead and hit play, and then I'll post some answers here for you. Okay, go ahead and check your answers now and see if you came up with the answers I have here. If you got something different, go ahead and back and try to rework it and see if you can get the correct answer. Okay, last two problems now. Go ahead and pause your video player there and work 45 and 46 and see if you come up with the same thing I'll show you here in just a second. Okay, go ahead and check your work here and see if it matches up with mine. See if your steps follow the same steps that I have here. If you made a mistake, go back and try to fix it.